So hi there, I'm Juliet, and I'm sitting here today at the very beautiful Men-an-Tol, which is this whole stone you see beside me. And this was formerly part of a stone circle. So we are blessed with a very rare, still and beautiful and sunny day here down in Cornwall. So I thought I would share one of my meditations and what really comes through and has come through for me when I spent time down at this space is really about unity and unity consciousness. So just see what comes through, inviting all those that feel called to just close their eyes and join me for a meditation. So as always, just releasing with the out-breath. Releasing anything that keeps you from being present in this space. Connecting in now with the beautiful energy of this very sacred Men-an-Tol stone. A space that's always open, I'm told. Always open to give healing vibes. Some sites require a little more activation, but this one is open all the time. So anytime you come and sit here, the healing vibes will be transmitted. It comes through the sacred central stone. Representative of infinity, of unity, of the whole of which we are all part. And we come and we attune to this frequency. It changes how we behave in life, for we start to recognize the other as us, and then we treat the other better. And when we're not treated well by the other, we recognize the pain from which this stems, and we do our part to help, not hinder, to heal, not judge. Easier said than done at the best of times. When we come to spaces like this and connect to these frequencies, it becomes our natural way of being. Because we want to sow seeds of well-being and harmony in the world. Not disharmony, not conflict. No matter if that's what we are receiving, we don't fight like with like. We fight it with peace and harmony. And we do this because we feel this way ourselves, because we're connected to the center of our being, to the core of our being, to that. And when we're connected to this space, it happens naturally, it ripples out of us. So taking the time to really tune into the center, the center of your being, because this really is the center of everything. There is nothing outside. We can hear it many times, we can comprehend it on one level, but the only way to really discover it is to journey very deeply inside, and to never falter in that mission, to keep going. On and on, all the way until you get to the goal. And this is possible. It might be difficult, but it's possible. And more, it's becoming possible as more and more people wake up. It accelerates the process of the whole. So taking your part as one of these pieces that helps to accelerate for the whole. In that way, you do your bit, even by silently sitting in meditation by yourself. You're helping the whole. By silently watching your thoughts, noticing when they're critical, noticing when they're judgmental against yourself or the other. Seeing if this attitude can shift, can be kinder to yourself and to others. Pretending something's not there. That's not how we heal. But by allowing yourself to take the space for yourself, to connect into the source of your well-being. For this is what will carry you through all the ups and downs and trials and tribulations which will keep coming. Because it's the nature of life. We don't need to be swept up in it. Can act from a balanced and centered space. And this is why we come here, to connect to this sacred space, to help us always remember the truth of our being, to unravel all the layers that have clouded our vision, so bit by bit we can come back to the essence of who we really are. And then our lights can shine. And forgiving yourself, this is not always possible. For it comes with highs and lows, good days, bad days, but this is all a part of it. All a part of the tumultuous process of growth, of inner growth. Becoming who we are, until one day you find you feel at peace with who you are. You have nothing to prove anymore, but you're complete. And this is when you can share your light more freely to all those who are seeking that same light. You can reflect back their own light to them. It's all the same light. So just being here now in this space, connecting to the inner light, feeling of gnosis, an essence which is the divine spark within, which we all carry. We can have something of an activation of that in this space. A remembrance of our inner divinity. So just feeling your inner light, connecting to your inner light. It's not outside, it's inside. Stop reaching outside for all the temporary gains and pleasures. I'm not saying you can't have any of them, but I'm saying they're not going to bring the desired fulfillment. Not until you've journeyed in and found this inner light, which impacts everything else. Just being still now. And silent. Because when you're silent, you can really connect to the inner voice, the inner stillness, in the center of your being. everything is inside. Everything else is just a reflection. So just really feeling that peace that exists within the center of your being. And if you can't feel it yet, know that it's there. It's just been covered up. It will take a little delayering to get you back. Come to time, so we give thanks to this beautiful space and all the beautiful higher beings that surround this space and make this work possible. And we just slowly come back to our bodies, so just moving the fingers and the toes, opening your eyes, and that's it from me. So thank you for joining me, and I hope to see you for another meditation soon.